Welcome back to my channel. We're in the tutorial series of creating a code app using MoonStack. In the last video, I have shown you how to display all the posts on the web browser using React. In this video, I will show you how to make some styling on the UI using Bootstrap. I have already opened my project on the code editor, but before we make some styling on our web page, I will install a module that helps us to run both the client and the server, and when I run npm run dev, both client and server will be start. That's module called concurrently, and run npm install and say concurrently. I also go to the bucket.json on the server side. I will go on the script here. It's replaced by start not in the chairs. Server. Not mon index.js in the client npm run start refit client currently npm run server npm run client. Okay, this stuff can help us to run both client and the server.
I will add a p tag, let's say on both. And then I run npm dev, npm run dev. We have an error. I will check on. Okay. Must be a space here. Okay, I will run again. Okay, it's working. So
the front end and the back end have run together. Okay, now we will make some styling on our web page. I open a new tab and go to Bootstrap. Get Bootstrap, and I will choose the version 4.3.1. I search for table. We will choose one table. Okay, just get this one. It's very simple. I will okay, I will come in here and I paste the table, click save, and I go to the web browser. Okay, it's a display like a table, but we need to set up the Bootstrap on our project. I click on get started. And we will copy the link here. I go to my index.html. I paste the CSS link. Next, I will copy the JavaScript files, and I also paste on the index.html file. I click save, and now I back to my React app. Okay. Okay. We have successfully set up the Bootstrap UI. Next, I will pipe on our data to this table. We will edit it to title, description, and category. Okay, let's one more column. And I will cut this code. I remove the symbol data. And the code here. Okay. Copy this. then. We had to put the ID here. Post ID. I click save. Okay, I back to. Okay. If we miss the description here, maybe our type of mistake. Description. Okay. Done. Because we use MongoDB, so our ID will be a string that's very long, so when we put here, maybe it's not very user friendly. As you see, it's the long string here, so I will use the index. We use the index. Index, and as well will be 1, 2, 3, 4. No, must be post. I'm gonna be only index. Next, I will put a class name. Container. So that our content will be on the middle of the page. You notice that in React.js we had to use class name instead of class. It will help our web page to be rendered in exact style. I click save and open the web browser. Okay, our container on the middle. You see what's different here? Okay. And okay, next I will put two button, edit and delete. Class name btn warning srip. Okay, we just give the href blank, and an icon, class name, edit button, and now one more button, delete button. Times circle.
adventure. Okay, I back to the web browser. Okay, the two buttons will have display. I will put a space between two buttons. NPSP. Okay. Oh, very nice. But the icon have not been displayed. It's just because we haven't add a link of phone. Awesome on the index.html. So I go to phone. Awesome. I'll click on start for free. And I use my email. Then they will send you an email that have the link of phone awesome. So I have already got my link, so I just paste on the index.html file. I open my index.html file. And I paste the link. If you don't got the link, I will provide you on the description of this video. Now I back to my browser, and you see how we got the icon from Phone Awesome. I will put one space here. So that it will look better. I use this. Okay, then it looks better. If you want to change another icon, you can go to the Phone Awesome web page and click on icon. For example, I will change the delete icon. Okay, I will type okay, let's choose this icon. I will copy this class and I pass on. Okay, I pass on this. Okay, I remove on the A tag and I back to my browser. Okay, the new delete icon display. Okay, in this video, I have show you how to styling the post list. We know how to use the Phone Awesome icon. If you see this video is useful for you, please help me to like this video and share it to the others and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video.